Welcome to Carbohydrates Part 4. In this tutorial, we'll focus on polysaccharides. Let's get started. Alrighty, so polysaccharides are basically polymers, and I know in the previous notes I said 10 monosaccharides, and this is just a good example I took from two different books. So basically, poly, many, many sugars linked together. And because there are so many sugars linked together, they are no longer soluble in water, but the hydroxyl groups can be hydrated, and so they often form thick suspensions. So where do we see polysaccharides? Well, starch, right? So if you've ever kind of took cornstarch in water, you could see that thick suspension. And glycogen. So these are two examples of important polysaccharides, and the role for these two they share is energy storage. The other common role for polysaccharides we'll see with cellulose, and that's more for structural support. So where do we encounter these polysaccharides? Starch is the energy storage molecule for plants. Within animals, it has a very similar structure, but we call it glycogen. So there are some structural differences between plants and animals and how we store energy. Basically, we take those extra glucose molecules and put them into polymers to store them for a rainy day. And then with cellulose, you could think about like the cellulose cell walls. So also for plants. Now, what's interesting then is that both starch and glycogen, they're going to use the alpha glycosidic linkages. And the interesting thing to me here is that we have the ability, right, we can digest starch, right? So when we eat plants, we can digest the starch. Right, so humans are able to digest starch and other animals. The cellulose, on the other hand, is not digested by humans. And even like with cows, right, so animals that can eat plants, right, the herbivores, they actually don't even have biochemistry to digest the cellulose. They have bacteria in their stomachs that have the right enzymes to break down the cellulose. So what is it that makes this distinction between being digestible or being an energy source for animals and not being digested? It comes down to the glycosidic linkages. Cellulose has the beta glycosidic linkages. So the difference between the glycosidic linkages leads to a lot of different things in biochemistry. So here we have a couple examples, right? So here are starch and glycogen, and they have very similar structures, and they'll have the important role of the alpha linkages. And we talked about those a lot in our disaccharide tutorial, so if you need to know more about glycosidic linkages, please go back to the part 3 video tutorials. The main thing I want you to note here is note that the alpha links, right, they create branching. And then if we compare that to cellulose with the beta links, notice how tightly that the polymers can align themselves. So notice the tight packing with the beta linkages. Okay, and then if you want to dig in deeper and look, here are the various, now there are some beta linkages in the starch and glycogen, but the dominant linkage is the alpha, and that's the one we're able to break down. So really, As far as polysaccharides go, for my class, that's all I really want you to focus on is recognizing the different biological roles of the three primary polysaccharides and the difference in the glycosidic linkages. So please take some time now to work a little homework to reinforce your understanding.